Guys, it's almost been a month since we finished our final year project, and we used to post photos of the same. So this is our project. This is my partner, colleague Pranil Raut, and you know me, Prathamesh Satardekar. So it's almost been a month and we didn't post any photos right now, but we have successfully finished our final year project. But we never ever demonstrated our project. Like, you wanted to see, many of you requested me that you wanted to see the working of this project, but I never posted any video. So I thought, since we have finished our third paper, this is the correct moment, as there is no one else in this lab, you can see. And so we have the perfect opportunity to check the demonstration as well as check the entire circuitry part of our project. Please do not imitate this project. It's a request. So right now, I guess Pranil will start with the working process, the working of the project. He will explain you the entire working. I'll just shoot it. So
as you can see, this is the system structure of our project, containing multiple lockers, 4 for mobile and last 2 for laptop. This is a slot where I have installed Android tablet containing Android application, which has a graphical user interface. This is the programmable coin acceptor, which accepts the coin. So let us quickly start with the demonstration purpose. So this is the by default screen. As you can see, there is an option available, connect and charge. So just click on that option. Then you can see number of lockers available. So by clicking on the locker tab, you can see availability of locker. So all the lockers are available, since there is no any mobile kept for charging. So let us take example of locker one. It is available, you can see. So let us go for next. So this is a rate screen where for 1 rupee, 30 minutes for mobile, 10 minutes for laptop, because laptop consumes much more power. For demonstration purpose, we have kept this time for 15 seconds. So let us go. I have to put 1 rupee coin into the coin acceptor. It accepts the coin and sends the signal to microcontroller. Microcontroller transmits that signal to Android tablet via Bluetooth. So just go to next. Then password screen, we have to enter the password. 4-digit password. So for now, I'm entering 1234 and then next. Again, it will ask to re-enter the password to make sure that we remember the password. So if I enter wrong password, like 1236, it won't accept the password. It will ask me to re-enter the password again. So again, 1234, and again enter the correct password, 1234. So just click on next. Now you can see tick sound. Locker one is now opened. This is the USB provided. Connect the phone to the USB, and now you can see the green LED which indicates the charging is going on. Charging is on. Okay, just keep phone for charging. These are the modules. This is the solenoid, and this is the sensor module which senses the lockers closing or opening. Just close the locker. Now you can see locker is locked. Now it is not opened. So this is, you can keep your phone charging for over here and just wander around. Your device is completely safe with these lockers. So again, now I want to remove the device. So again, I will come over here, connect and charge. Then now you can see locker one is not available. It is unavailable since I have preoccupied that locker. So click on next. It will ask me whether I want to remove device or not. So yes, I want to remove device. I will click on yes. If I click on no, I will go to default screen. So I have to enter my password. If I enter wrong password, it won't open the locker. So my password was 1234. I have entered corrected password. Now click on next. Now locker is open. Locker is open. I can disconnect my phone and again close the locker. It will get closed. So now let us go for this all for mobile lockers. Let us go for laptop lockers. Just again click on next. Again select the locker. Locker 5 and 6 are for laptop. Click on next. Now you have to enter the coin. You have to insert the coin. I am putting 1 rupee coin. Then again click on next. Again set the password. This time I am setting password 1122. As you can see the password. Re-enter the password 1122. Next. Now you can see locker 5 is now open, and there is 3 pin socket provided which provides 230 volt 50 hertz to the laptop charger. You have to connect your charger along with the laptop so that your laptop will get charged. After putting the laptop inside, you have to close the locker. After closing the locker, it will automatically detect and locker will automatically get locked. So now you can see locker is locked. It is not opened. So same procedure for checkout, you have to follow the same procedure as I have explained. And this is the front end process. Let us go for back end process, whatever is present in back side. So this will be explained by Prathamesh because he has done extensive work. So
I'll be explaining with the circuitry part. We'll just have to move this till then I hand over the camera to Pranil. So here, please hold it. We'll just switch off this system right now as we have to just show you the circuitry part.
Second video.
So here we are having four modules of 5 volt 2 ampere each. Each consists of a transformer and a regulation circuit which provides that power. So each one is for one locker. This is for locker 1, locker 2, locker 3 and locker 4. This is the circuit routing for locker number 5 and 6. It just routes 230 volt from main supply to the locker. This is the main circuit where we get 230 volt input and it provides 3 ampere and 12 volts for working of the entire PCBs or all circuitry. Then we have a fan regulation circuit which just provides power to this fan. Then here we have a signal routing which is required for sensor modules and the solenoids for locking purpose. So they just provide power from the signal obtained from this circuit. And this circuit is the main microcontroller circuit which is used for interfacing Android tablet to microcontroller. So we have a Bluetooth module as well, and the entire control signals go from microcontroller circuits to this routing circuits. So this is a basic control circuitry. Then we have the coin modules. This is how it looks from front end, and this is how it looks at the back. And this is the coin accepting box, we can say. We collect the coins here, and then we have fixed this tablet here. So this is how it looks from the back side. And then we can just have a look to the wires that go from the back inside the lockers. So these are all the wires. The USB is connected to provide 5 volt 2 ampere, and then those are the signal lines and control lines for solenoid and sensors.
So great.
So and then we have this AC AC circuits. These two wires are providing 230 volt AC. So that was all about a circuit. I guess you need to just replay this video more number of times to understand our project if you want to know about it in detail. So that's all, and that's all what you had expected and we have provided you. So thank you for watching.